Welcome to art. Today we're going to be making some snowflakes of our own out of pipe cleaners and beads. But before we do that, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about an artist who was totally fascinated by snowflakes, and he was able to photograph them using a microscope. And when you look at these photographs, I want you to notice that yes, each snowflake is unique. That means each one is slightly different, but they're also all similar. So these are really cool, beautiful photographs. So let's take a look. In 1880, when Wilson Bentley was 15 years old, his mother got him a microscope for his birthday. He used it to look at leaves and flowers and pebbles and all kinds of things from nature up close. One day, he was able to capture a single snowflake and put it under his microscope. It was so exquisitely beautiful that he wanted to draw it, but it melted away so quickly that he wasn't able to capture it fast enough. He decided that he was going to attach a camera to his microscope so he could photograph the snowflakes up close. Here are some examples of Wilson Bentley's photographs of real snowflakes. As you can see, each one is different, but they come in different styles and they're all kind of similar. He thought it was his mission to preserve the beauty of these quickly melting miracles. In order to make our own snowflakes, we're going to take our six pipe cleaners and group them into three groups of two. So make an X by twisting the two pipe cleaners together in the middle, and then you'll have three X's. Now we're going to twist these two X's together by putting them like that, right? Letting them meet at the center, and then we're going to twist them together like so. There. Now I'm going to take the third X. Oops, mine came apart. I'm just going to give it just a simple twist in the middle, and then I'm going to put that right in the center of my first X and twist it around. So now I have what looks like a star. If you'd like to, you could trim the ends so that they'll be even. So I'm just going to trim this end here so that the two pipe cleaners are the same length. So now it's time to start putting our beads on. Grab one group of two pipe cleaners, and you're going to put both pipe cleaners through one hole on each bead. So I'm just going to continue going all the way around and putting the two pipe cleaners in the hole of one bead. Now, you can put a few more beads on both if you want, like I did on this other one, or you can start separating the two pipe cleaners right now with just one bead on. So now you see that I have one bead and then it opens up like the letter V. And now all we have to do is put beads on each pipe cleaner individually until we're happy with the results. Leave a little bit of extra on the end of each pipe cleaner so that you can fold the pipe cleaner over at the end so the beads won't fall off, like this.
Thank you. Thank you.